Okay, whenever the market gets hammered like this, you're going to get buying opportunities. Some of them are a lot more obvious than others. Take Coupa Software, C-O-U-P. That's the cloud-based software company that helps businesses identify cost savings in procurement and spending. I know it sounds boring, but listen to me. They call themselves the Salesforce.com of expense management, and they are. Now, Coupa reported a fantastic quarter last night, but because the cloud stocks are out of favor right now, they initially sold off. It was down 5%. That was crazy. It was stupid. And because the company had delivered a massive 14-cent earnings beat off of a 6-cent basis, higher than expected sales, free cash flow good, and management raised their full-year forecast dramatically. But the market didn't initially care. Eventually, the stock, let's say the market came to its senses, stock closed up 0.7%. But any other day, I think it would have been up 10. Don't take it from me, though. Let's check in with Rob Bernshteyn. He's the chairman and CEO of Coupa Software. Learn more about the quarter and his company's prospects. Mr. Bernshteyn, welcome back to Mad Money. Good to see you. Good to see you. Thank you, Rob.
Good to be with you, John.
Okay, first, there's a lot of difficulty and a lot of people understanding whether stocks are guiding up or how well they did. Yours was the most massive beat that I've seen. And in particularly, I'm going to mention one number. So better than expected, $22 million versus a $2 million consensus, 50, you're up more than 50%. How are you capable of doing that with something that I have to tell you is as prosaic and boring as procurement?
Well, Jim, look, whether economic times are good or bad, there's one thing you could definitively control, and that's your spend. Right. And our customers are doing that to the tune of over $1.5 trillion globally and growing very, very rapidly. And we're growing through their customer advocacy. We're growing through their referenceability. We're taking it one customer at a time. And these customers are letting others in their industry and others in their function know about the value we're delivering for them. Through this growth, we've been able to sustain, you know, over 10 years of rapid growth, but also thoughtful expenditures on sales and marketing and great cash flow situation as well.
This is not one of those overnight successes. You've worked very hard. Last time we talked about how much money P&G has saved, they actually referenced on the call that they've been saving money in procurement. I know you spend a lot of time with BMW, a gigantic automobile company that must spend and spend. What are you capable of doing for them?
We're really proud to have earned the business of BMW. We have other automotive companies as well, divisions of Toyota, right. Audi, Rolls-Royce, and others. But BMW is a recent customer, recent member of our Coupa community, and we're going to help them manage all of their source-to-contract capabilities. We're going to apply information to technology to their procure-to-pay processes. We're going to help them get their arms around all their categories of spend, delight their end users, help them prioritize where to save, and hopefully over time help them save not only tens of millions of euros, but perhaps hundreds of millions of euros as we manage our relationship with them over the coming years.
And yet there are other companies where it just seems like, I know in the conference call it's excellent, all congratulations by the analysts, that sometimes when people hire you, they save $1 million instantly. How's that possible?
Well, first of all, we've aggregated buy-side demand from our customer community. We've negotiated with dozens of suppliers across a whole host of commodities. So the minute they become a member of the Coupa community, they have access to preferential pricing with a whole host of these suppliers. And these are best-in-class preferred suppliers. Now, they could take advantage of them. They could choose to use their own contracts to do what they like. But many choose to take advantage of that and get value on day one.
So people tell me, okay, Jim, what is this Coupa Cabana? What is this Coupa? What is it, Copa? It actually stands for something. Run it down.
It does stand for something. These are our vision areas. Okay. The C stands for comprehensive. That means every area of business spending, everything from procurement, invoicing, expensing, payments, sourcing, supply risk management. We help companies get their arms around all of it. The O stands for open, a very different spirit of interaction. You know, our industry, I've been in it for 26 years now, it's not really known for having an open spirit with customers.
No.
A lot of demos and a lot of customers often get technology that doesn't really work for them.
Right.
We make sure that every one of our customers gets measurable value in working with us, and that means an open spirit of exchange with them from day one. The U stands for user centricity. The only way that you can get spend under management is if your end users all over the world, from high-tech companies like Snap to Spotify to financial services companies, Blackstone to BlackRock, ground crew at United or American Airlines, they have to engage with the solution. So we're helping them get massive spend under management through this focus on simplicity and user centricity. The P stands for prescriptive. This is where we leverage the insights of our entire community of customers for the benefit of each individual customer. We can let them know these are suppliers you should stay away from. They're not delivering well for our community. They're not trustworthy. They're not shipping on time. They're over-invoicing.
Wow. Okay.
And the A stands for accelerated. That means time to value. Mid-market customers going live 3 to 4 months. Big enterprise global deployments going live in 8 months. And with every one of these, we learn and get better and better and better.
All right, so let me present, because it is hard to rebut the presumption of wanting to hire you. I'm SAP, Bill McDermott now moving, but I'm Bill McDermott watching. I'm Oracle. And I'm saying, okay, let's see, C stands for O, stand. I'm just going to do the same thing. Why can't Oracle, SAP, mimic you?
Well, the first thing I'd say, this is a huge total addressable market, over 50 okay. billion by our calculations, and we're very early into penetrating this market. We have a lot of marquee customers all over the world, hundreds and hundreds, but we're still very early. But we're not a products company, Jim.
Right.
First of all, we're obviously a cloud company, you understand that.
Right.
But we're really a value as a service company. So we're delivering measurable, quantifiable value through the use of our best practices and our technology. And if those companies can overcome the classic innovator's dilemma and enter a true cloud value as a service approach that we're taking, well, perhaps we'll see them in the market.
Well, it's clearly working. The acceleration is just beautiful. I want to congratulate you. And just so people know, I mean, I talk about a lot of companies like ServiceNow up 49%, Salesforce up 18%, Adobe up 20% for 1 year, Coupa up 131%. Rob Bernshteyn, CEO of Coupa Software. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you.
Booyah! Jim Cramer here from Mad Money. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube. Click here to subscribe and get the jump on my exclusives with CEOs, plus market news, investing advice, and a whole lot more.